Like, kung bakit ikaw yung pinipili namin na, pinipili namin na nagsiserve dyan. And kung ano yung role mo sa team, parang di nila nakita yung lahat ng tinutulong mo during trainings. Kasi ang nakita lang nila is the 2 hours, 3 hours of the game. Di naman nila nakita yung hirap mo with the team every day for 5 hours every day. Diba? So, anyway, syempre ako, gusto ko pa rin like, i-prove sa sarili ko na alam mo yun, nakaya ko pa rin, ganyan. So, every day, super pinapush ko sarili ko. So, lahat ng games after nun, hindi na ako nag-error ng service. And then, nung mga last games na, like last 2 games na yung nag-error ako once, tapos yung isa nag-error ako once. Hindi naman na yung like before na talaga twice. Pero syempre, dahil nga ano pa rin siya, syempre, pinapasok ako sa sobrang crucial yung pa-end na. Hindi ko ma-explain kung gaano kadali. Sobrang dali mag-service, guys. Alam natin yun kasi it's one of the basic things na tinuturo when you start. But it's really different when wala kang kapawis-pawis. Tapos, papasok ka last minute. And, syempre, ikaw, ayaw mo rin naman mag-error, diba? Kasi, siguro nga, minsan, sa sobrang iniisip mo na wag mag-error, minsan, baka nga dun na rin. Alam mo yun? Tapos, alam mo yun, na-regain ko na yung, yun nga yung sabi ko, diba yung sabi nga dito na, hindi basis ng self-worth mo, yung work na ginagawa mo, and yung sinasabi ng ibang tao. Tapos biglang nangyari na naman yun yung nag-error ako. Parang sabi ko, tas yun na, mayroon na namang mga nag-message na parang kung gusto niyo manalo yung PLDT, wag niyo na ipasok si Jessey, dali yun. Alam mo yung parang first time ko ever in my life. Kasi coming from UST na, alam mo yun, na never ko na, or siguro hindi ko lang nakita, pero yung pagbabash, first time ko talaga like, mabash. As in parang, hindi ako naging ready for it kasi sabi ko nga sa inyo, diba, I always give my 110% sa games. Or di lang sa games, sa Arky, sa lahat ng ginagawa ko. Tapos, makakabasa ka ng parang patalo, si Jessey patalo. Parang, diba, parang kahit sabihin ng mga teammates ko na hindi naman nila alam na yung, I mean, Jessey, ba't ka nanginig sa ganyan? Eh, hello, di nila alam yung kapag... Diba kami yung kalaban ng first six kapag ano, alam mo yun? Tsaka yung help na natutulong mo sa team, hindi lang ako to ah, but sa lahat ng part sa team, yung laki ng tinutulong nila sa team, parang hindi yun nakita ng mga tao. Tapos, wala lang, ano, nagkaroon lang na time na sobrang hindi ko kaya talaga. Parang feel ko parang kailangan ko na ba mag-stop mag-volleyball, ganong level na talaga. Pero, yun nga, siguro dahil rin sa support ng teammates ko, support ng coaches, support ng friends, parang sila rin yung mismo nagsabi na parang hindi nila alam. Hindi nila alam yung paghihirap nyo araw-araw sa training. Like, the whole team, hindi lang ako. So, para lang mabash ng mga tao, alam mo yun. So, yun yung tinatry ko pang i-unlearn. Because it's easy for me to say na hindi ko binabase yung self-worth ko sa sinasabi ng ibang tao. But every time na makakabasa ka ng message, ng hate message, parang hindi lang, di ba, parang kahit sa'yo din, di ba, parang hindi nila alam yung mga taong nag-hate, they don't know the effect of their hate to the person that they're hating. Kasi at the end of the day, lahat naman tayo, tao pa rin. And at the end of the day, lahat tayo, pinaghihirapan lahat kung nasan tayo ngayon. So, yeah, yun lang yung, ang dami kong sinabi. Wala lang, parang ang sad. Di ko na nababasa yung messages ko. Pero, yun yung pinaka mahirap i-unlearn. Yung wag mo masyadong isipin yung sinasabi sa'yo ng ibang tao. But, yeah. Sobrang nakaka-help yung ibang tao. Ayoko na, busay. So, ikaw naman.
What was the question?
Sabi mo about self-worth. Not basing your self-worth with what people think and your work.
For me, self-worth, I mean, I guess I think I'm really, really hard on myself. So when I'm not able to achieve like what I thought I would achieve, like in my head, like
yeah.
I get super down.
I guess yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, it's hard to, because you have such high expectations for yourself. Yeah. And then when you're not able to meet them, you're like, what the heck? I thought I was better than this. Like, you know, it's, for me, I am my, what is it? What is the saying? I am my worst enemy.
May nagtanong, baby, where do you think yun galing? Like, why are you so hard on yourself growing up with it?
For me, it's not like, I'm hard on myself because I feel like my parents and my family have high expectations. But, you know, my parents never forced me. They never put any extra pressure on me. But it's more of, like, my self-fulfillment. And it's like, you know, I want to make them proud. I want to make my family proud. So I'm going to do the best that I can. And it's like, it's not because my parents pressure me. Or, you know,
yeah,
it's more of myself.
Same. Feel ko parang nade-develop yun since dahil sobrang hardworking mo as a person. Parang feel mo dapat, di naman siya directly, pero subconsciously, you think na dahil nga ang dami mong nagagawang bagay na malalaki, parang meron, dun mo na nasaset yung expectations mo sa sarili mo, na mas kaya mo pa. No?
Yeah. True. I'm my worst enemy.
Yeah.
Same. Good evening, honey.
Okay, guys. 1:50 muna. 150K. Bago mag-next. No! Thank you!
I like chocolate.
Thank you.
What's that? I haven't seen
that before.
It's a new... More pa.
More pa. Kita.
Honey. Hey, honey.
Si Adelia.
Adelia, stop.
Arte.
Ayan. Nagaling ka mabudol, di ka pa niyang bubudol sa lagay na yun, ha?
Ate, stop! Ano ba? Ano ba? Ayan na si Hi, Mary!
That's Mary?
I don't know. I don't know who Mary is.
Sabi mo Mary?
Yeah, because I read Mary.
Held on a little lamb.
Okay. We're waiting for 150.
Guys, press one if Jessey looks like
yun ka na naman.
Alice
yun
from
ka
Twilight
na naman.
Alice from
ikaw
Twilight
lang nagsabi niyan. Ako. Sa hair, yes hair, because it's kind of red. I think her hair is kind of red.
Somebody Alice from Twilight.
Yeah, it's the hair, guys. It's the hair. Okay. Yan na, malapit na. 10K na lang. Tapos we can, ano na.
What are the other gifts here that are new? Can I look?
Okay.
Can I drop? Am I allowed to drop? No, I can't, huh? Oh,
yeah. Yeah, you can drop. Tweens, wala na ako pang drop. Oh.
Very good, Sammy Day.
Oh,
I am proud of you. It's okay, don't drop. Next time, no.
Well, again, the budule natin si.
Ah, sorry. Well, okay.
Si Sammy Day.
Hey, so what are the new gifts?
At Jamila.
Sorry, mo no. Yamas.
Musta na daw si Jupi.
Yamas starter.
Ah, the guitar.
The guitar.
Cutie.
Wata, yung store, yun
na yung, ano, yun na yung diwa, pagbubudol mo. Oh, you it tell them why, ano, what's our goal? It's because of the camera.
Hey, guys, if you want to support us and our content, help us by dropping because we want the X100B.
No, it's not a campaign. Just drop.
It's Whatever your heart desires. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We're trying to get the X100B.
Yeah. So the goal tonight is 2 million. Hmm? Why? There's nothing impossible.
Sorry.
Thank you. I just checked your Bora vlog and you manifested a jowa. Ba? Tama ba?
Manifest. I have been manifested.
Wow. Ade, wow. Okay naman. Swerte naman. Sobrang swerte.
Guys, this is Bobo. Because...
Hi, honey. Honey, honey.
That's honey. Remember we took a picture with honey at the game?
Oh, yeah.
Honey.
Hi, honey. Yung nagbigay na ano? Yung ano? Or yung sa chat ko? Thank you, Ansi.
Yeah. The Gaviscon.
Yeah, the Gaviscon.
Yeah. That's honey. The clutch honey.
Sobrang sakto. Dun siya sa ano. Uy, huwag kayo umiyok. Diba ang cute ni Boba?
Bobo!
Ay, Bobo, sorry. May nagsalagay kasi ng Boba. Sabi ko talay Boba. Ayan, hindi na lang, 1K na lang.
Drop na kayo.
Ba't pag ikaw nagsasabi, ang cute?
Mag-drop na kayo.
Drop na kayo. Okay, 150. Okay, next. Where's my phone?
Ano to? What are your favorite flavors of boba? I like fruit tea. I like mango fruit tea with boba. She likes regular milk tea with boba. She doesn't even know her order because I order it.
Okay, next. What do you want to unlearn? Somebody answered. Oh, no, wala.
Family pic screenshot though.
No.
Corny.
Okay. Okay. Ang tagal, okay na yun. Figo naka-screenshot yeah. Sila. Okay. Next. I wanna unlearn blaming myself for not knowing better.
Ouch. Okay. What are your thoughts about it? loading.
Well,
you can't learn unless you fail, you know? You have to go through some like rough patches. You have to.
That's what I was telling them.
Yeah, you have to mess up. You have to make it. Like, you can't be perfect. You can't know everything.
Yeah.
The only way to grow is by learning from what we have done wrong in the past.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So.
You gotta go. That's what I was telling them a while ago when you were still not here.
Mm-hmm.
But you have new viewers, so very good.
Don't be afraid to make mistakes because that's how you learn in life.
I was telling them, I won't be able to tell you my experiences, I mean them, mm-hmm. my experiences, and tell them na you have to go through this or like, paano ako napunta sa situation na naging mentally tough ako sa isang situation. I think it all happened because I was able to go through it, like, made mistakes, went through that certain situation, parang made the wrong choice or something like that. Kasi hindi ako matututo without it.
Yeah. Yes, we are training every day for SEA Games.
Okay, next!
Lot.
Yeah. I want to learn how to think in advance or overthink.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with being planned and organized and trying to think of possible scenarios that may happen. But also sometimes you have to learn how to just live as you go, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like it's okay to be planned and okay to be organized, but it's also okay to let go and be spontaneous sometimes. Because life is spontaneous.
I think she's referring to, like, overthinking. Like, alam mo yung making scenarios in
your head that's not helping.
Feel ko may, ano, mayroon siyang certain boundary dapat for overthinking. Sometimes it becomes unhealthy when it's too much already.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not yet happening and you're over-worrying. That makes it unhealthy for you because, of course, you can't sleep anymore or you can't think straight anymore because you're overthinking of scenarios that are not yet happening pa naman, diba? So, yeah.
I don't have an answer for that because I'm like that.
Yeah. Me too. I'm an overthinker. So, same, I want to unlearn being an overthinker.
Ay,
diba?
Sherry. Yeah, I don't know. When I'm worrying about something,
we need the mic.
When I'm overthinking, I spiral. You know that. I spiral. I go on spirals.
But sometimes I just need to let everything out and then I'll feel better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, hello, bye.
Hey, this is JJ.
Joy, joy.
Prisoner. Your thoughts na nag-start sa what if maybe mag-spend na ng energy. Because, again,
thoughts na.
Yung thoughts na nag-start sa what if. Ang hirap kasi sa what if. Well, hindi man natin masasagot yung what if unless mangyari na. Diba? Nakamukha na tayo. Mas cute ka? What if someone take you for granted?
Bye. You tell them why you don't notice me.
Sure.
Hey, why you don't notice me?
Yeah. Maybe communicate with them first. Communicate your feelings to them. And then if they don't act upon it or change, then maybe it's time to let them go.
Yeah. Ako nasabi ko na yung thoughts ko about that. Ayoko na ulitin. Simple, bye. Yeah, because sometimes I think the reason why she said na you have to communicate that is because some people who take people for granted, they don't know that they're already taking them for granted. And that's why it's important na you communicate it so that they know. So, ibang usapan na kapag ginagawa pa rin nila, they take for granted ka pa rin nila, it means it's time to let them go.
They don't care.
Because you're already wasting your energy. And it's important that you spend your energy sa right people who are also giving you
reciprocating
the same energy. Yeah. Yes. Hi guys, 170. Let's reach 170 next before the next one.
Non-negotiables in relationships.
Uy, hindi na yan related dito! Next time na yan! Guys, may next episode pa kami about ganyan, about love life. Dito muna tayo sa ano, what do you guys want to unlearn? Wait namin yung prison manager mag-top up.
What do I want to unlearn?
Ikaw, what do you want to unlearn? Ops, 170 first. Ubus na po. Oo, sige, isip ka muna.
Pot of gold!
Cute! So, we learned a lot. Oh, that's nice. Thank you, Lion. Thank you, Jensky. Thank you, Gelatissimo.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, honey.
Let's go, honey.
Honey, honey.
Honey, honey. Honey, honey. Honey, honey.
Have you thought of what you want to learn?
No.
You're looking at the other answers.
I feel
answers.
Like an airhead. I can't think of anything.
Thank you.
Can you believe that you tracked what you want?
Make her believe that you want this relationship more than she does, in my opinion. Do you believe that you attract what you are? Like, if you're toxic, you attract toxic people. Toxic. Just kidding. Okay. Oh, thank you, Peach. Actually, before. Hi, guys. So, dati, akala ko. At sobrang. Sige, sagutin natin to kahit unrelated. So, you believe that you're toxic. Ay, that you attract what you are. Like, if you're toxic, you attract toxic. Ano ba? Kasi ako, I've been. In toxic relationships. And after being in toxic relationships, sobrang tagal bago ako nagkaroon ng next because I wanted my next na hindi na siya talaga toxic. So, nagkaroon ako ng reflection na baka ako talaga yung toxic kaya sila toxic. Pero siguro, ang na-realize ko sa mga sa pag-reflect, feel ko, meron talaga akong factor. Well, kasi sa relationship natin, diba, dalawa nga yun, it takes two to tango. So, so feel ko, meron talagang part na ako rin toxic. Kaya, toxic rin yung relationship ko. Tapos, nagkaroon ako ng fear before going into a relationship na baka ako talaga yung toxic. Baka na ina-attract ko lang talaga toxic. Pero well, hindi kasi hindi man siya toxic.
Sure.
Pero na-realize ko, baka kasi nakilala ko na yung sarili ko. Gets? Lagi ko sinasabi kasi, before going to a relationship, you should know yourself first. Kasi, knowing yourself first and loving yourself first will make you realize or like will make you ano ba more brain fart. Okay, so yung point ko is kapag kailan mo sarili mo alam mo kung ano yung ayaw mo at gusto mo, lagi ko talaga ito sinasabi kasi tinatanong ako eh kung paano mo malaman kung ready ka na. So by the time na alam mo na sarili mo, alam mo kung ano yung deserve mo, yan. In tune with what you deserve. So, hindi ka na papayag na may papasok sa life mo na hindi mo deserve. Like, for example, yun yan. Hindi ka tinatrap. Ito lang maayos. Okay, bye. Diba? So, feel ko before, what makes me toxic is I don't know who I am. Kasi I am letting people treat me like this and just letting me treat me like this just because I love them. So in short, I don't love myself. Kasi I let them treat me bad eh. Just because I love them. Gets ba? Although I can't say naman, ay, hindi ko naman sabi na like, ako sobrang clear ako, hindi ako toxic or anything. I've been toxic also. But feel ko kaya na-attract ko na yung hindi toxic is because I know myself better now and I love myself and I love this person the way I love myself. So yeah, like what I've been saying before sila dumating, diba? You have to love yourself first because you can only love a person when you love yourself. And tinatanong kasi nila kung masama ba na sobrang magmahal. Sabi ko, hindi man masama magmahal ng sobra as long as you're giving the same love to yourself. Diba?
True.
Facts. Hindi ko alam kung anong ginawa. Okay, guys, 170.
yung sarili mo. Drip na ganyan.
Classmates!
Yay! Thank you, Laya. Thank you, Gelatissimo.
For the Harana? Maybe not tonight. Maybe on another night. My throat is not ready. But thank you. But thank you, boss. I'm marathoning with you.
Yeah, I know. Thank you! Ang cute nung large carlinator.
Right person, wrong timing is a real thing. It's happening, I guess.
Yeah? Fico, kasi when it comes to people na dumating sa'yo ng wrong timing, I think they came for a purpose. No? Thank you, Adelaya!
Sabi mo, JJ.
Nangihintay lang kami ng 1K para ano
na. Wah! We're already at 169.
Yes. Yay! Tara, thank you, JJ.
I like chocolate.
Thank you, I guess.
More pa!
Ayan.
What's the next?
Okay, next.
What I want to unlearn?
Yes,
I don't know if I have an answer. Maybe being so hard on myself. And knowing when it's okay to give up on something. Because sometimes, like, I don't like to be known for as a person that gives up on things, but there's also a time when you should get. I don't know, like, you know, my work situation. I battle with that in my mind. I don't like knowing that I gave up on something. Yeah.
Good.
Like, so I want to give something up.
Kahit sabing daming cons.
Yeah.
Dahil lang ayaw mo masabing nag-give up.
Pero alam niyo yung parang sabi nila na pag nag-give up, kapag nag-give up minsan, yun din yung meron ding give up na yun yung totoong strength.
Yeah.
Like, knowing when to give up.
Yeah. Knowing when to give up. Yeah.
It can be like,
nilalim mo na. Thought.
Yeah, knowing when to leave, knowing your worth, period.
Yeah, that's how I call her too.
Peach. Mango pie.
I think it's human nature din talaga. Sometimes when there's still one reason to stay, we still stay. Even though there are more reasons to leave or give up. Wala namang atake dapat yun.
If I'm yourself caring about that person.
Okay, 190.
Okay.
Yeah, because that's what I call.
Yeah, no. Don't change your name.
And before she wanted to change. Oh yeah. Getting a Neutrogena.
No, because I feel that because even with my other job that I had in the States during the pandemic, I had a hard time knowing when to quit that because I didn't want to be thrown into the unknown.
Yeah.
I like this sense of security and familiarity. I like knowing that I had a paycheck every month. You know? Yeah.
I think that also happens with relationships.
Yeah?
I just mean, sorry.
I got a job in the US. I worked at a music store.